Down. I'm your host, Austin Creed. But I'm technically not the host of this episode. This is being thrown to the fantastic Miss Emba Moon.
That's right. This is my episode of Up, Up, Down, Down. And I guess.
Or your series.
My series. And I guess we got to change the name a little bit because it isn't video games. It's Dungeons and Dragons that we're playing. And we're going to call it Roll Out.
Introduce yourself.
You got me, Brendan Williams, the Shogun.
Oh.
And I play a little bit of tabletops. I play a little bit, so that's why I'm here, right?
That's why he's here.
I got my start in the fields of LARPing. Heck yeah.
Yeah.
Well, I LARPed with
best of them?
Yeah, with the best of them. With the best of them.
I've LARPed with the best.
That's how you got signed.
And now I'm rolling with the rest. That's my introduction.
Perfect. And
I think he's insulted us, right?
We're the rest. We're not the best.
I'm used to the best, and now I have these idiots.
No, I'm here with
them. No, we're friends. Yes. It says here that
That's
we
true.
Are friends.
That's true.
For three levels.
That's true.
Okay. Are you gonna introduce yourself?
Yeah, bam.
He needs no introduction.
Hey guys, my name's Tyler Breeze.
Oh, why is it so soft?
Because I'm using it.
Yeah.
For those of you who have not played tabletop games before, our Dungeon Master will unfold everything for us, and we will explore this magical world that he has created for us. Can you tell them who you are and what you do?
Yeah, so I'm Arthur, or Art, or whatever you want to call me. Dungeon Master's fine. Long time gamer. I've been playing Dungeons & Dragons for, as we just discovered recently, longer than all of these people have been alive.
Yay!
You look great.
So I've been playing Dungeons & Dragons. Thank you. So I've been playing Dungeons & Dragons since I was 11, which was 35 years ago. So I've been through every incarnation of the game there is, and I'm here to have some fun. Let's do some killing.
Perfect.
I do have to say, I love your shirt.
Oh, I do too, yes.
Come on.
What?
It's
a great shirt.
So as we discussed earlier, you guys are a group. You guys have been friends for about three levels of your characters now, so you've done quite a bit of adventuring together. You guys were in the city of Neverwinter.
We have a crew!
I got surprises for you.
I thought that was just the logo on the screen of the show.
I got surprises, look at this.
What?
So that's you guys sick. Were up here in the city of Neverwinter.
Yes, Neverwinter.
Neverwinter.
And you met a dwarf named Gundren Rockseeker. And Gundren hired you guys to take a wagon load of supplies from Neverwinter to the small town of Phandalin. Phandalin used to be a big mining town, but the mine dried up, had some problems, and it's kind of become like a hive of scum and villainy, as things go. And so he's given you a pristine amount of 10 gold pieces apiece.
Good money.
Some high money to escort this wagon of supplies from Neverwinter to Phandalin.
An escort mission.
He, however, has told you, I have business, though. I have to go ahead of you guys. So he has hired a man named Sildar Hallwinter, which is a human, to escort him ahead of you guys, because wagons are slow. It's going to take you guys a couple of days to get there, to go ahead with him to Phandalin, handle some business. You are to take the wagon to a place called Barthen's Provisions, and it's a trading post. And he will meet you guys there, and he will have your 10 gold pieces apiece. And you are to bring your wagon there. So this is where we can have all you guys introduce your characters. Number one, so the rest of the party knows what, because you guys have all known each other. So you guys know what each other are, and so the viewers at home can also know what your characters are. So
okay.
Go ahead.
Okay, so my name is Sasha. I'm a lady. I feel great.
It's not intimidating at all, man.
Why does it need to be intimidating?
I don't know. You just said like it was going to be.
The ones who are intimidating are the ones who aren't intimidating.
I know.
See, the quiet ones. I'm 17 years old. I'm 5'8". I'm 135 pounds. I got green eyes, tan skin, and tan hair. Wow, don't mess with me or I'll shoot you with my crossbow. Yep. And I got magic. So I carry a crossbow, a short sword.
There it is.
I speak the deep speech. If you know what I mean.
Ooh. Oh. Is it?
And what's your race, Sasha?
My race is Tabaxi.
Which is a cat person.
I'm a cat person?
A cat person?
Yes!
Yes!
Easy, Sasha. Easy, Sasha.
Sasha.
Easy.
Don't put water on me. Your turn.
Yeah, follow that one.
Follow that. Yeah, have fun. Have fun with that one.
I can't. He's so excited. My name is Calliope. I'm a rogue. My race is Eladrin.
Eladrin. Elves.
Elves.
Magical elves.
Oh, yeah. Elves.
I'm a magical elf.
I love elves.
And I'm very good. What kind? But I'm also a spy.
No, like this kind of like.
I'm 21, 5'6". I like long strolls on the beach and.
I feel like we're on like dating websites.
That's what you do with yours.
My profile
17,
says I like
and I'm
dice.
Looking for another kid.
How old is 17 in cat years?
That's pretty old.
So old. I'm just looking for some milk to drink out the bowl.
Sitting here like,
oh my God, Sasha, stop it. Stop it. No, stop. Oh my God, no.
This is gonna be the whole episode. All
right. Sasha, stop.
All right.
We'll never catch a man like that.
I am serious. Nice. I'm a mercenary veteran, a dragonborn. I'm also filled with experience from my military past.
He's a half dwagon?
I'm a half dragon.
He's a half dwagon.
I spit acid.
Oh.
Oh, and I'm like 30 years old and like long walks on the beach and all that.
You're so old.
I'm not even that old in real life.
To me, you are. I'm 17. Oh, hey guys.
Yeah, you're the fourth. You're the fourth.
I'm a wizard.
Okay.
Is it Harry Potter?
I'm a half orc. But I'm also young and gigantic. I'm 25, 6'3", and 245.
Thick. What wizard is that? She's thinking like Gandalf style?
No, there's no Gandalfs here, mister.
Yeah, I'm telling you. So I'm a gigantic in my head.
What's your name again?
Yeah, what's your name?
Oh, my name is Turok.
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 Okay. Turok or Turok?
Turok.
Like, are you saying Turok or?
Like the game, like remember
Turok.
That? Remember,
like, yeah. Turok.
Yeah, remember like.
I feel like you're putting an emphasis on the U.
Turok.
See, you are.
No, I'm putting it on an O.
It's his name, you can say it all.
But that's why I want to get it right, so I don't mess it up later.
Turok.
Turok. Like to rock or not to rock.
No, I rock.
So you guys have been traveling on the Tribor Trail, which is this little dotted line here, for a couple of days. As you come around a corner, you see on our map up here, you're going to see there are two horses down in the middle of the road. They have got black arrows stuck out of them, and they are dead. The woods, as you can see, the trees on the map press pretty close to the trail here, and there are deep thickets everywhere. So we'll put you guys in the wagon, if you guys want to take the four minis we have and put them in the wagon.
Put us in the wagon.
Or around the wagon, however you want to be placed.
You can
placed.
Sit next to me, Toro.
Who's driving the wagon?
I would like to be who's like the in the middle of the tall people.
I'll drive. I'm third.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
Placement.
Bam.
So Sirius wants to drive, so put Sirius up
dude.
In front.
Yeah.
Put me in the front.
Is this you?
He's a warrior.
Yeah.
Half the wagon?
Put me in the front, girl.
Is that Sasha in the middle? The little backpack and
no, that's Calliope. Oh. I always that's gotta be Sasha like incognito. Right, guys, I think we need to stop for a second.
What?
Some stuff has gone down here. There's some arrows and some horses, and this just looks like a sketchy situation.
It appears that there was an ambush.
And I feel like with all the bushes. Oh, excuse me. I feel like with all of the bushes around.
Oh my God, Sasha, what's up?
I really feel like we need to make sure that there's no other people before we get out and just all willy nilly.
That's all.
I think someone needs to go to the bushes there, because I really just feel like we should maybe avoid this situation at all costs. Like, I'm not gonna go over there in the bushes.
Well, I have no one.
But I don't want to do it. Like,
I have no problem visiting the bushes, but one of you might be able to sneak a little better than I.
Yeah, but. You know what? Like, I just can't right now.
It's
like,
fine, girl. I'm just... I'll do it myself.
I'm gonna check out these bushes. Have my back, friends.
Look here, tank.
I got your back with my crossbow.
Yeah.
Look, guys.
Take your crossbow train.
So go ahead, Turok. You can really... move your, or Sirius, you can Sirius. Move your character forward a little.
You
little
should
bit.
Go in the first the bush.
What bushes are we talking about?
So these are the sketchy bushes here. Go in the first bush. Don't walk down the road. What are you doing?
Okay.
You were
that's
talking
a, that's
about
a tree.
Soldier here.
That's look, a tree.
It's look, a tree. Those are the
trees. It's a tree bush.
Go around the tree bush situation, like there. So,
okay.
Bam. You talk about
wait,
sneaking.
Now you're going deeper in the woods.
Betsy Driver much. You wouldn't even go.
Who'd have to put you in charge?
Look. I'm the most attractive person here, all right?
Debatable.
Back off on my camera.
No, it's not.
what do you see?
Oh my God.
Yeah, so give me a perception check, Sirias.
Okay.
So yeah. Roll your die 20 and add your perception score, which is on the on your skill list there.
Oh, right there, plus one. So I got six. I don't six. See anything.
Yep, so you come around that side of the tree and it is pretty thick in here. Like the undergrowth is pretty thick. And you're not really seeing a heck of a lot in here.
I see nothing over here, girl.
Go further.
And Turok.
Look, I'm just saying maybe you should go further.
You know what? You know what? I feel like you don't want to go over there and look because you can't.
Whoa. No, I can totally do it if I want to.
Perhaps you could send someone more perceptive than I.
Well, it's not going to be her because she can't do it.
You know, I go over there because I got to prove a point to Sasha over here. Like, I'm going to go over here.
I will have your back.
Bam, you better have my back, Tank. Bam, right there.
What is tank?
Okay, now Sasha can give me a, or Calliope can give me a Calliope. Perception check.
Gonna dare me to do some stuff.
I'm confusing my girls up there.
Yeah, don't confuse us, we're very different.
She's a cat. I know.
Meow.
Well, you know, yeah. Dogs, cats, right. You know,
perception, meow. Where's that?
Wow.
20.
Woo! All right.
Not a nat 20. But.
Not a nat 20, right. So as Cal, Calliope, Cal, whichever you want to call it, gets over here, and sees the big, massive Sirias by the tree. You get the glint of metal.
Nice.
You didn't see that?
I didn't see it. That's why I asked you.
And at this point, we'll roll initiative.
Oh, fight time! It's fight time.
Good thing you saw that.
I watched the wagon, guys.
I would have went right back.
So you have an initiative score in the top center of your page next to your armor class. Every roll a die 20 and add that number. I'll go down the list and find out what you got. Sasha, what do you got?
All together, 5.
Ooh,
nice.
Calliope.
7.
Sirias.
17.
Okay. 17, okay. All right, Turok.
9.
I was waiting for him to go first.
Yeah.
So we have a joke at home about cleric speed.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. It's just trash.
Cleric's always going last.
Yep. Yeah. Yep.
So, monsters.
I'm going last.
Ooh. Oh, I rolled a 5. I rolled a 3, actually.
We're getting straight to the action.
Okay.
It's good. A little
bit of action right off the bat. So, let's go to the
I'm right there. I'm ready for
it.
Swing on it. So.
Swing on them fools!
Swing on them fools. Bet you won't hit them.
Is there a battle music?
So, look up on the screen.
Okay. Little goblins.
We got some goblins.
Step on them.
We got two of them here that look like this guy here on the left, mm-hmm. which is heavily armored, using maces, these big spiked maces down here. Mm-hmm. And then the two towards the back on the map, towards the horses, look like this guy over here, who are archers who are ready. So Calliope, you happen to see the one that's closest to you first, the one over on the left of the board, mm-hmm. Closest to you, and you see the glint of the metal off of his armor. However, it's not quite
what
fast enough. Sirias is obviously a very experienced soldier, because he jumps to the action faster than anybody, so he gets to go first.
Yeah. Can I say to the trees?
I see some blurry stuff, but I don't know.
Appropriate thing I can say right
now.
To the trees!
Yeah.
Do I see the other one in the tree here? Yes, I
do. You do manage to catch the two that are on the side of the road that you happen to be on.
So, I will direct Sirias to the trees on our side of the road here.
Okay.
Blindly walking.
Since he is just very spry in action right there.
He's so spry.
I will also direct my other friends to the other trees.
Okay.
You and divide and conquer.
Well, they're going to get to you guys before we can help you out.
Well, but if we follow behind you,
look,
I got the crossbow.
Well, maybe we should regroup.
Or how about you start crossbowing the trees over here?
Well, it's not his turn.
Yeah, I go last. I go last.
We'll get there then.
Cleric speed. It's gonna be a little, while.
I'll let everybody else get
theirs first. So, Sirius, you get to go first.
All right. Well, do I see that somebody has a bow and arrow?
Yeah. Now that she's pointed out that there's metal in the trees, you kind of take a quick look and you do manage to catch this guy over here. Actually, give me a perception check. Let's see what you see.
Okay.
He's not very perceptive.
You know what?
I'm not very perceptive.
Wait. You get advantage.
I do.
Because she has pointed it out.
Oh, okay.
Where that? So hang on. Advantage.
Big dice. Big dice.
Roll out. Dun, dun, dun.
Where do I gotta be? Right here?
Throw him against the wall.
Big roll against the wall.
Oh, against the wall. Remember?
Oh, against the wall.
Yeah.
There you go.
All right, here we go.
Too hard, you're gonna come back. You got it.
There you go, good.
Yeah, that one's out of there.
Three.
Oh, that that's over. A 20. 20.
We'll
that's a 20. 20.
See it?
We'll take the 20. So with the natural 20, yes, you definitely pick up the other archer in this tree over here on that side. And even with your keen eyes, those dragon eyes, those slitted dragon eyes, not filtering out the bright, bright light, you managed to catch the other two on the other side of the trail. You've got all of them.
I see all of them.
Critical perception!
Love getting crits on
perception.
Oh, I saw that.
Saw that.
I think it would be best if we regroup. They have archers. So I'm going to grab the girl.
Did you figure that out when the arrows were in the horses or like when you saw everything?
Dang. This could be a different group.
Should I leave you so you have to wait your turn?
I'm behind you, so.
All right. Can I grab her and bring her back to the wagon and use it as cover?
You can grab her and bring her back to the wagon if you like.
All right, come girl. You come with me.
Okay, so Sirius grabs you and drags you back over to the wagon for some protection from the arrows, I assume. Mm-hmm.
Yes. Yeah. I like how he placed me right in the middle of everyone. He knew how small I was.
Right, there you go. See, some small.
Easily carried.
He's a carrying half
wagon. All right, so Sirius is good there. So the next one to go is the monsters. They move a little faster than some of the slow pokes around here. So, clear speed. They're not going clear speed.
That's
so,
us.
So slow. This monster over here is going to make a little bit of a move.
Here we go.
Come right up on Sasha.
Sasha.
Let's go. What you want?
Got that shield though.
Yeah, I got a shield.
This one's going to move up, but he's going to fall short.
Fall short.
He's going to move again.
Everyone
falls short.
Just watching each other.
Yeah.
Just a stare down.
Just wait until it's my turn.
You make a move, I'll make a move.
And these two come over this rock. Cropping right here.
Okay.
Outcropping of rocks. And they're hiding behind the rocks.
Cowards.
With their bows. And they will begin shooting at the party. So we'll start with the melee guys first, who is the first one on Sasha.
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 Okay, let's go.
Block,
what
block.
You want?
He brings back that big metal spiky mace on you.
And then I dodge.
And he gets a 15. Did that hit?
Cool. What am I looking for?
Armor class is in the middle. It looks like a shield. Class?
18!
Oh,
18!
Nice, quick. Nice.
So quick, she goes.
Yeah. The 15 bounces off your armor, dealing little to no.
She buffed me!
And the other one over on the other side, going after Sirius. The big armored giant he is. And we got a. Ooh, that one's a little better. Oh, no, that's a 15 as well. Does
that
hit?
Is not enough.
That's not enough. Another one glances off the armor.
Nice.
The two archers don't have a really good shot on anybody except Sirius and Sasha, so they're going to attack the two of them. The wagon's in the way for Turok and Cal, who are in the back over there. So the first archer firing at Sasha. A 15 does nothing. This die only rolls 12, apparently.
Off of me.
And the other one, oh no, that was not a 12. That was a 19, so that's 22.
That's on me? Yeah, that's gonna hit me.
So, first blood has been drawn. All right, you take 4 massive points of damage from an arrow that just hits you in the shoulder.
It's okay, that didn't hurt you. Oh, God.
Yeah.
All right, so the next one to go is Turok.
I'm fine.
How much life you got?
Turok.
I got 24.
Good. Turok.
I have no fear. I will strike this man before me.
That's not.
Wait, what do you got?
Turok.
You're still nursing your wound.
Yeah.
Turok, it's your turn.
What do I want to do? Do I want to attack someone?
Yeah. Probably.
Yeah. I think I want to attack someone.
Yeah, yeah, probably.
Maybe that guy who's right in front of us. In front of you.
You can do that for sure.
Right?
We'll give him one, two.
What would you like to do on him, Tarak?
I think I want to firebolt him.
Oh, there you go. Firebolt's a good one.
Yeah. Okay, so to firebolt him, what do I do?
So roll your die 20, add your bonus to your firebolt, which I believe is like 4, right?
Plus 4.
Yep, attack so bonus? Roll and add, yep, and add your 4 to that.
11.
15. So 15. So 15 is not quite enough. So it impacts on his armor. They are pretty heavily armored, those two guys up in the front. So it kind of hits the armor. Yeah. There's a little bit of a red glow for a couple seconds, and then it kind of cools back out.
Starting to cook him.
Yeah, cook him slowly. Cook him slowly. You don't want to cook him too fast. But does no damage for you.
Damn. I was just warning him.
And next one up there. Anything? Do you want to move or anything, Tarak, or you want to stay hidden behind the wagon?
I like to think I'm standing on top of the wagon.
Oh, on top of the wagon, okay. Throwing magic, just flinging magic.
But my guy's huge, so they went for you instead.
Yeah. Right. Yeah. Okay, so Cal, Calliope, it is now your turn. So the big thing with your rogue character is you have the ability, which you got a second level, whereas a bonus action, you can disengage or you can hide.
That's kind of what I'm thinking about doing. I want to stab and hide.
Right, so the good thing about the rogue is you can move in and stab and use your bonus action to disengage and move back without getting hit. You can kind of jump in and stick and then leave.
Done, let's go for the stick and run.
All right, so you're gonna go up to the one and stick him and run?
Stick him and run.
All right, so go ahead and make your shot. Sneak attack. Take your attack.
All right. Oh, that's miss. Jesus. That's
come
a.
Come on, man.
Come on. We're also beautiful stuff.
This is rough.
It's gonna be a shame.
You're gonna be taking some more damage here.
Considering that was a 2, because I got a -1 to strength, I'm just gonna.
Oh no, but you get dex bonus. So look at your attack bonus with your.
No, I rolled a 3, so that's not gonna help anything.
Right, that's not gonna help much. I think your attack bonus is like a
5.
A 5, yeah. So you have an 8, but still not gonna help. Yeah, you go in there to stab, and it hits the armor and just does nothing.
All right, so I choose to hide.
You're hiding.
I do have a question. If I run to hide,
yep.
Do people see me go run to hide, since it's a part of like my rogue ability?
Yeah. But you are so small, and you're kind of behind some of the bigger guys. The archers may have a harder time finding you.
They watched you with your feeble attack, and then you ran away.
Oh, she's gone.
Yeah. Where can I hide? Can I go?
You could probably go over to the trees, or you could go to the rocks back there by the edge of the map.
Yeah, go to the trees, and then you can hit him from the back.
Oh. Yeah, there you go.
Nice.
Now you're thinking like a military man.
Now give me a stealth roll.
Oh, stealth.
So roll dice.
Oh, please. Come on. Just run in the bushes. Oh, man.
Stealth.
Might not be good.
I think it's a +7.
Okay, 14.
14, okay, that's decent. All right, okay. So you think you're pretty well hidden. You've gone over to a tree.
You think you're doing a good job.
There's some bushes, and you're in there, you're in the bushes, but you know.
I'm in the bushes, guys.
Who knows what happens at that point? And now last, but certainly not least, our cat friend, Sasha.
I have a question.
Yes.
So with my attacks here,
yep.
My guiding bolt.
Yep.
Can I just do that as many times as I want?
Well, no, guiding bolt is one of, I think it's second level. Look at your spells, flip to your third page.
Oh, yeah.
The other ones, you have spell slots that you need to ration them out.
You can touch one willing creature. Oh, jeez. Okay.
I like how he just didn't even phase that. He was like, I'm willing.
Doesn't even care what it's about. It could be anything.
I don't know what it is.
I'm willing.
Okay,
Serious.
Wait, my Word of Radiance, I can just do. Ooh, dope. Okay, so that's everyone that I can see.
Everyone within five feet.
Within five feet.
Yep.
Which we got two within 5 feet.
There's just, within 5 feet of you. So right now there's just one within 5 feet.
Ah, okay. Can I move around? Move me behind Sirius. So I'm more hidden from the other guys.
So there's an action called disengage.
Yes.
If you do not disengage as your action, and you move and do something else, the guy that you're currently engaged with gets to try and stab you.
Attack of opportunity.
That's right. Okay, you're gonna let him take a shot
at you? Do you want to disengage first?
Wait, who? Oh, he's...
He can hit you as you move.
He's hacking at you as you run away.
I get what you mean. No, I'm mess him up.
You're gonna let him loose.
You're gonna stay right there and attack him.
I'm gonna stay right there. Guiding bolt on
him. Is that how they do it?
Attack.
Guiding bolt on
him.
Because I have to get the guiding bolt back, I have to go to sleep, yes?
Yes.
Yeah, screw it.
All right. Guiding.
So go over to Guiding Bolt on your spell cards.
I'm trying to help you out. Let's see.
What does Guiding Bolt say?
Guiding Bolt, one action, range 120 feet, duration one round.
Right in front of you.
A flash of light streaks toward a creature of your choice within range. Make a ranged spell attack against the target. On hit, target takes 4d6 radiant damage.
Nice.
And the next attack roll made against this target before the end of your turn has advantage, thanks to the mythical dim light glittering on the target till then.
So, if you hit the one that's in melee combat with you, you'll have disadvantage because you're in melee combat. However, if you throw it over at the other one, you'd soften him up a little bit for the rest of your party to get a good shot at him and do some damage on him.
Let's do that.
Okay, so go ahead and make your attack roll, add your guiding bolt, whatever your bonus is for guiding bolt. Yep.
I'm not going to roll on the book anymore. 8. Added to what?
Whatever your guiding bolt says in the middle there.
Guiding bolt plus 4, so 12.
12. 12 is not enough.
Perfect. Ooh, so does that mean that I burned it and I can't cast it again?
You've used the spell slot for it.
Yes.
However, you do have inspiration.
Oh.
You could give me your inspiration if you'd like, and you could roll another d20 and take the better of the two.
I'll give you my inspiration.
Give me that big inspiration die. These are inspiration dice.
Inspiration.
I'll take that, consume it for the DM. Take a second roll here and let's see how it goes.
There we are.
16.
Plus?
No, 19.
That's
19. That's 61. I rolled a 61.
61.
Yeah.
That's enough, right?
19.
Plus your guiding bolt.
Plus guiding bolt is plus 4.
So 23 is a solid hit. So the guiding bolt streaks across, goes over the wagon, hits the guy on the other side. Roll your damage. Roll your 4d6.
One.
Four dice? Well done, girl.
Do you need some dice?
I need some dice.
There's 3.
I don't want to see it like that. Okay.
It's okay, Sasha. I got you, girl.
Thanks, girl.
I got you, girl.
I think you get this.
Okay.
2, 6, 2, 5.
So just add them up.
Okay. Don't mean
11 plus 4.
4. What?
11 plus 4.
Yeah. Or 10 plus 5. Bam. How's that for math?
Crazy.
Is this the new 15. Math that we're doing?
This way, is
the same amount.
Why would you go then 11 plus 4? Why don't you go 10 plus 5?
Because the 6 and 5 were side by side together.
Yeah, but that's harder
math.
And
then the 2 twos were side by side together.
This is more difficult
How
math.
Is that hard?
It's harder. I didn't say hard. Harder. Anyway, this is the slowest game probably you've ever
been part of.
Okay,
so 15 points. That bolt of light hits him nice and hard. He does not look good after that bolt. That bolt hits really hard. He's not looking good at all. Uh-huh. Then we flip around back to the top of the order.
Ah, yes.
And Sirias gets to go.
Now it's time to strike this man.
Am I the only one who hit somebody?
Yeah.
I preheated the other.
So yeah, everybody else is lining them up.
Sirias, you now have advantage on your attack roll. The first person to attack him because of the guiding bolt. You get to roll the two big dice.
Yeah.
Hey, good. Get that crit again.
Big die.
All
right.
There you go. Ready?
Here we go.
Roll them up.
Are you
guys
this
small? 19.
Oh, 19 is what?
Yeah,
it's a crit.
We have critical hit deck. Oh. So there's a critical hit deck right up here in the middle of the table. Grab the top card for you. You're a slash attack, so you are the top one, or whatever the top one says.
Slice tendon, triple damage, and the target speed is reduced to 5 feet until the end of the target.
Oh, triple damage!
He's dead. He's so dead.
So roll your damage. So what does your damage say for your attack?
Look at your attack. My damage is for my halberd. 1d10 plus 3 slashing, and I have plus 5.
So, you get to roll 1d10 3 times.
Damn.
Or 3d10.
All right, here we go.
Oh, we got a 10.
5. 10.
Yeah.
4.
Okay, so that's what? That's 10 points of damage plus your 3 from your strength.
Plus
so
my
that
3.
Is 13. And that slays the goblin. How do you kill your goblin?
Ooh.
I plunge my halberd deep into its chest.
All right. Well, actually, cut his tendon.
I cut his
leg right off.
Yeah, I just took his leg right off from beneath
him. So that goblin has been fallen by the mighty Sirias, lies here on the ground. It's gurgling.
Yeah.
I'm gonna grab his leg.
Gurgling. And
can I loot him?
Dying.
Can I loot him?
We'll loot
You're
after.
Not close enough.
I have no qualms stealing from the dead.
No qualms stealing?
Hey, would you mind doing me a favor? Would you cut out two of his teeth? Front two teeth, please, so I can have them
for
the end of the fight.
Yeah, I can do it after if we survive.
We're still in the middle of a fight, guys.
Where are we having conversations? Where's this discussion coming from?
Mid-combat.
Can I have his teeth?
Can I get his teeth?
However many teeth you can get.
You're in combat over here.
If you can, hold, just get, let me.
Yeah, you got a guy right in front of you.
I'm the reason that this guy's dead, so just give me what I need.
I just want to loot him.
I believe I am the reason he's dead.
If you can give me as many teeth from his mouth as you can, I'd
appreciate it. I only cut off his leg, his teeth should be fine.
Okay, I'll get the teeth after we're done then. Okay, fine, whatever.
What are you talking about?
We need the
anyway,
teeth
let's go.
All right, now it is the monster's turn. So, we got the one guy who still is in melee with Sasha. So he's gonna take another swing at Sasha, hoping to hit this time. Oh, and I think he might hit.
Or I think he might not.
19.
Dang!
Oh, he does.
But my armor class is 18, so he barely hurts
right,
me.
Right, he barely gets you. So he brings and brings back that big old mace, and he smacks you with it for four vicious points down.
Four?
Ooh. All right, the other two. They're gonna see it. We're gonna see if they know where Sasha or Calliope is.
They'll find her.
They don't seem to know where Calliope is at all.
Great. Heck yeah. So I kind of think I know what I'm doing. Hiding.
Now that Turok was nice enough to point out the fact that he's standing in the back of the wagon where everybody can see him.
Yeah.
The two goblins with bows
just screaming.
That's right.
Do you have drums?
My hands are on fire. Everything's on fire.
The two goblins with bows are gonna take shots at Turok. 13.
I have 11.
Oh, that's good.
I should probably take cover.
Yes!
What are you doing?
And a 22.
So and
22!
So two arrows come streaking into a Turok.
Right in the eyes.
For 4 points of damage each. Turok takes two hits.
Come on.
So wait, so how much damage?
Four each, so 8.
Oh my god. Down to 12.
Come on!
Turok probably shouldn't be standing in the
wagon. Turok, get off the wagon!
20 hits.
Get off the wagon!
Oh, something to point out, Turok. You have a spell called Mage Armor.
Yeah. Oh, I do. Yeah.
It lasts for 8 hours.
I might need to put that on.
You might want to put that on.
I might need to put that on.
It gives you a base armor class of 13 plus your dexterity bonus, so that'll give you a little bit of an armor class.
I'll need it.
So that's a spell you might want to cast sometime soon.
Yeah, I'll do that.
Can you give that to other people, too?
He cannot. It's personal. Personal only.
Not personal armor.
But on number 9, Turok, it's your turn. The monsters have gone.
Well, I want to put some armor on, man.
That's a good idea. And the good thing is it lasts for 8 hours. So you'll have it for pretty much most of the day.
Nice.
Good.
Okay, so how do I do that?
So you can just say that you're casting it. You have 4 first level spell slots. It will take one of your slots.
And that's it?
Yep. So you spend one of your spell slots, you cast Mage Armor. Like for the rest of you, what you see is like this shimmery ghost-like armor of like force kind of like wraps around Turok. Obviously giving him some sort of
I think Turok is the most
protection.
Beautiful member of our party.
I am now. I'm glowing.
He is now a tree.
It's kind of fitting, isn't it? and do you want to move or anything, Turok, or are you going to hang out in the back of the wagon next morning?
I may hop down off the wagon.
Oh, that's a good idea.
Just, I'm kind
of tired. Go ahead and move your guy a little bit. Just
move me behind you, man.
Yeah, you go. Hide behind the fighter. Good idea. All right, so Turok is done. Calliope, it is now your turn. The hidden one.
She's you guys be mad if I stay here?
Of course she's gonna stay there.
She's gonna stay there?
Of course she's gonna stay there.
We're friends.
Go stand on top of the wagon.
You're just gonna let us all die?
That's what a solid plan is.
We're learning about each other. I bet you can't hurt the person directly in front of me.
Oh.
Nice.
How do you even know like where I am right now? How do you know?
I don't know
because
where you
we
are.
Saw
you're not hiding from us.
Yeah. And I'm just screaming this. I'm screaming. I don't have to know where you are. I'm just screaming. I don't know where you are. But you can't hit the person in front of me, Cal. Yeah. You never could, and you never will.
I'll show him.
Yeah.
Her.
Can I?
Her. Her. She. Okay.
I get distracted by
She's
the
a
cat first sometimes. Can I?
Yeah. What?
Because we have a wagon here, right?
Yeah.
Can I use my awesome athletics that I'm proficient in to kind of like do a vault over said cow and do a sneak attack?
Absolutely.
Sick.
On the goblin.
Give me an athletics check.
Check those athletics, girl. What's the street running? What's
the
parkour?
17 plus 1, 18.
Oh yeah. So Calliope comes running over. She vaults over the wagon, landing her next to the goblin. Go ahead and put yourself next to the goblin over there.
Well, I want to dive stab this goblin.
Yeah,
Right. Still in the air. Still in the air.
I'm like here.
Keep it in the air.
I'm here.
Yeah, you know you're here. Keep it in the air.
Sit there and hold it. I'm going to give him a perception check to see if he sees it coming. which he does not.
Oh, yes!
So that means.
Do I get advantage?
You can have advantage, which means roll the dice.
Roll the dice!
Big dice!
I was gonna do a dance and then couldn't pick it up.
Hey, yeah,
you just hit them all head first.
All right.
Don't throw them so hard the camera will be able to pick them up.
We're good. Oh, 16 plus.
Plus five?
Plus five, so 21 is a solid hit.
Sneak attack.
Where were you aiming?
Sneak attack. His head.
Right in the head, okay. So you also get the, you get sneak attack on this. So remember, you do a die six with your sword and two die six with your sneak attack, plus your dexterity bonus of three. So you do three die six plus three.
Let me just reach into my dice here and just.
Somehow I think she's taunting you with dice.
Why don't you look at me while you're stealing your dice?
Yeah.
So.
Yes, I agree.
So 1d6 for the sword, and then 2d6 for the sneak attack, and then add the dex.
Add your dex bonus, yep.
Are these if I level up the next ones?
Oh no, those are the Cyclops ones.
Ooh.
Yep, okay.
Ah.
12 points damage.
12 points, ooh, that is a nice shot. So that's a nice strike. You get him like right in the neck, like a nice hit.
He just kind of moves slightly.
Does not take him out though. He's still standing.
I'm gonna clean up.
Not feeling too good though. You can take your bonus action.
Yes.
You can.
I go hide.
You're gonna go hide?
Oh, you're
come
the
on.
Worst. Where are you hiding?
In the bush.
You're gonna have a great character arc too. When you don't hide one day.
Well, it's behind him. He doesn't know what hit him. Right, do I need to roll a...
Yep, give me a stealth check.
9 plus 7, 16.
Okay, I gotcha. All right, so you kind of, you jump in, give him a good stab in the neck, and like, I'm out, guys, and you kind of slip out.
He's like,
go back over behind, don't blend in the bushes.
Ooh.
Oh, I'm bleeding out of my neck.
Very nice strike, like very nice. Sasha, it is now your turn.
Better kill it, Sasha.
What do you got, Sash?
What do I have? I got some good stuff.
I got some drifts.
So he's hurting in front of me.
Oh, he's hurting.
I imagine, is he still focused on me or is he like, what the F just stabbed me in my head?
Yeah, he's kind of cranked his head around to the right a little bit. He's just trying to find out what just stabbed him in the neck and then somehow disappeared, like ran off in the woods. Like.
Yes, but still looking at me. Okay, so if I disengage, are disengaging and moving the same?
No, disengage is an action, moving is your move action. So, the problem is if you disengage, you can't then cast the spell.
Okay. Two moves, right?
Right.
Disengage is a run.
Well, disengage is not movement. It's just kind of backing out slowly.
So a guy can't
whack you.
Ooh, yeah. I'm gonna change it from Word of Radiance to Solar Flare.
There you go. All right.
I'm gonna hit him with Solar Flare.
All right. So what does it say that the saving throw is?
So it says. Each creature of your choice that you see within a range must succeed on a constitution saving throw or take 1d6 radiant damage.
Okay. All right, so a constitution saving throw. So he rolls, adds his constitution bonus, gets a whopping 4. Your saving throw is on your third page. It says DC at the top. Your spell save DC in the middle.
12.
So 12, so 4 does not make 12, so he fails. So you get to do your die 6 damage.
You better kill it.
We're a great team.
We're a
4.
Four, and that will be enough.
You can get your own team.
On my next attack, though, I'm out of attacks. No, I still have.
No, you're done. That was
no,
your
you're
action.
Done.
Yep, you're good there.
If I didn't move.
Well, you can still move. You can still move.
Where are you moving?
Does moving count as cutting his teeth out of his mouth?
No, that'd be an action.
Okay, fair.
Might want to save that for after the battle.
Yeah.
Okay.
They're going to be there. They're dead.
I don't know what's going to happen.
I can't speak.
I need the teeth for something I want
to
do. We're in the middle of a battle. You're going to ask me stuff.
We're going to get
you the teeth.
You're
going to
get your teeth.
Hiding anyway.
You're hiding. Do you want everyone to know where you are?
Shit.
Exactly.
I'm telepathically speaking to you.
You're just hiding.
Oh, since when? Since when?
Where does it say that on your sheet?
Yeah. Okay. So I successfully dropped this guy in front of me single-handedly. Whose turn is it?
Oh, yeah.
Let's go.
Do you want to move or are you going to stay?
I'm going to. Can I get in the wagon? Is there a question? The wagon. Is it like old school, like Wild Wild West wagon?
No, it's an open wagon.
Wild Wild West.
There is like a tarp.
It's a Wild Wild West wagon. It's got like.
It's not like a spider.
Can I get behind. Whoa, hold on.
You should get on top of the wagon.
Get under the wagon.
Hold on, well, that's what I was gonna do, but I need to make sure I can do something.
No, you can't, like, Mission Impossible, like, underneath.
Yeah, you can.
six squares.
Hey, are there six squares in between me and the archers right now?
One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight.
Can I move,
into
the bushes to the, on this side of Cal?
Yeah.
You guys are all
inside?
Just in front of the wagon, but he's
fine. Just in front of the wagon.
Cowards.
Am I?
Deal with that, you know.
You can certainly try.
Yeah, I want to try to be stealthy. I want to try to sneak into those bushes.
Yep, so the problem with stealth with you is going to be you're in big clunky armor.
Okay.
So you get a disadvantage on your roll, but you can certainly try.
Oh, they're going to see
I'll try.
For sure.
All right, so disadvantage is the big guys.
Big guy, big guy!
And you take the lower number, so unlike your friends who've taken the higher number, you have the lower number.
You should not have tried to hide, man.
Yeah, watch me.
You should have just hit under the wagon.
I have been blessed.
Lower number is a seven, so add your stealth to the seven.
Oh, there's no way they didn't see you.
They saw you.
They saw you, they heard you. They're coming for you.
They smell you.
Where's my stealth?
You left your cat
fur. Right next to your stats where the bonus are, there's a whole line of skills.
We're going to have to protect it out.
Four.
Four, so 11.
11?
It's not terrible.
Have you finger math? Finger math? It's not terrible. Could have been better.
No, you said it like that is terrible. I'm trying to make you feel good.
Yes, I do. So?
Least stealthy cat around.
Next.
I'm in big armor.
That's your fault.
I'm a big cat. What is that? Oh, wow.
That's an unhappy cat.
You're making the game slow. We gotta keep moving.
You guys are close?
Sirias, it is your turn.
No, it's my turn.
Yes.
All right, well, I'm going to make sure my cat friend doesn't die.
Yeah, you gotta get up there.
So.
I'm not gonna be able to get to those archers in one turn, right?
Well, you could do a move action and move six squares, as your action, you could run up two.
Do they have a disadvantage shooting an arrow at me if I'm right in their face?
Yes.
Okay,
yes.
Then I'm going to take two move actions, and I'm going to get in front of this archer who can probably see.
Nice.
Sash.
Yep. You just stared him down.
Yeah,
Thank you.
What you gonna do?
Yeah. Well, so they will have the same problem.
So aggressive.
Sorry. I don't know about that. Maybe
he's our warriors, dude. He's got it.
maybe a different phrase.
So yeah, they'll have the same problem attacking you unless they move away and attack. But if they move away and attack, you'll get to whack them with your
attack
caliber,
of opportunity. So. Everybody.
Well, with a panicked look in their eyes, these two drop their bows and pull out little knives.
Uh-oh.
And they're just gonna. Get him some dragon fillet.
Yeah.
It's half the wagon fillet. Half the wagon fillet.
They're gonna take a shot at it.
Filet mignon dragon.
I didn't realize
there's a 17
half hit.
Yes, it does.
Oh, it does. So there's a little stab for two.
Okay.
2 points of damage.
I'm still all right.
And the other one gets an 11, which is not gonna hit.
That's not good.
Look at his cat. You have dead eyes. You didn't make it.
No, I'm surprised. Oh, you got stabbed for me, thank you.
Since when is surprise the X's? X's are dead every time.
No.
Always dead.
Have never been surprised in any form of media.
Here, okay, so who's next?
How do you make that emoji on your phone?
You put a grave next to a cat smiling.
Nine, Tarak, it's your turn, Tarak.
What do I want to do? I might want to move up. I'll move up next to the little kitty.
Yeah, come through.
Next to that
come through, come on. Yeah. Come on, Tarak, with your fire hands.
I go in with three,
hey,
I go
you
six.
You need to stop that. You need
how's
to calm
your,
down.
How's your sneak?
Girl, he got the fire.
So I can move, what, six?
Yep, you can move six.
You got that fire. You got that fire.
One, two, three.
Let him hit something first.
Yeah, I'll move right up here. I'll move
you're not
right
in the bushes.
Here.
You're right in the middle of the road.
You're in front of the wagon.
Yeah.
You're not hiding at all.
He's got armor.
I don't need to hide. They got those little knives out. They're stabbing him.
Yeah. Oh,
he's so brave.
I'm good. I'm in the clear.
You're right.
I'm back here just comforting you.
Okay, thank you.
And petting you. I like cats, man. I'm trying to firebolt this guy.
Okay. All
right,
go right ahead.
He's right in front of me. I might as well.
Take a shot.
Take a shot.
Actually, do I want to firebolt him or do I want to scorching ray him?
Ooh. Scorching fillet. Right?
So I mean the bonus better, is right? The bonus is firebolt is free. It's because it's a cantrip, so you can throw firebolts all day long. Whereas your scorching ray is a second level spell. It uses your resources.
I'll save it just in case. I'll firebolt them.
Firebolt's a good one. Go ahead, make your roll.
So that's what.
Die 20 plus your attack roll, which I think was a 4, 10. Right?
Plus 4.
Yep.
Yeah.
So roll and.
Got a 20.
A natural 20?
Yes!
That's a crit!
Yeah.
Critical hit, go over and grab a die.
Actually,
or a card, I mean, a card.
So
and
so if I got 20 on the die, but then I also have a plus 4, is that 24?
Yes.
But a natural 20
always
hits.
So because you're using fire, you're gonna use the bottom critical, whatever the bottom one is.
Terrifying display.
Ooh.
Triple damage.
Ooh.
And all enemies that can see you must make a DC 14 wisdom saving throw.
Cowards.
On a failed save, they are frightened of you for 1d4 plus one round.
Oh, okay, so let's roll your damage first and see what it does to this guy. So I believe the firebolt's a die 8, I think, correct?
1d10.
Oh, d10, so roll three of those, because you did triple damage.
So my fire looks terrible. I can't draw fire.
Okay, so I got a 9, a 1, and a 3.
So that's 13 points damage.
Yep.
Which is going to drop this goblin. He has fallen.
Dead. Is he dead?
Yep, he's dead.
Do you lay a lamb
right on? Yeah, triple that damage.
That fireball just melts a hole right in his chest.
Now the other guy, he can't see me because he's in front of him, right?
Well, no, he can still see you.
He saw what just happened.
He saw his friend just melt.
He saw what just happened.
So he's got to make a DC 14.
He's spitting hot fire. Dylon! That's what I'm calling you for now. Dylon! You're from the Chappelle Show? When he's just rapping? Who are the five best rappers of all time?
Dylon.
Why? Because I spit on fire!
Now, Clive, you see fear in this goblin's eyes. He is terrified at this point. He may even be in the process of dropping his weapon. You're not entirely sure. He looks a little bit scared.
Did he pee himself?
There's a little bit of pee.
He peed.
There's a little spot.
Get him, he peed!
Just a little dribble.
If you don't kill him, I'm doing something very embarrassing to him. And when it's my turn, if you don't kill him.
And take his
teeth. Can you actually make sure to not kill him?
Okay, so So if you're using a melee weapon, and you hit somebody, and you reduce them to 0 hit points, you can choose to knock them out instead of killing them.
Please knock him out.
Mm-hmm. So that is an option.
Because then
we can torture him.
Do we keep him as a prisoner?
No, we don't.
Oh.
Okay. So, what have you got?
What have you done?
So, Calliope doesn't seem to come up to engage the fight that's happening out of
what?
There.
Nobody.
What'd you do?
Nobody.
What? What'd you do? What'd you do?
Said I rolled the guy near me?
Yep. What so she's going over and pilfering through the pockets.
Are you just looting people? You're looting people in the back?
You are my least favorite person in this group of my friends.
I thought I had no qualms about stealing from the dead.
We can steal from them, but at least wait until we won.
Yeah, Breeze's favorite thing to do is burgle people.
I was going to burgle the guy in front of me instead of fire tap.
That would be my action. And then
so
I would like
to... So we were next to him.
You disgust me.
She's a hider.
I'm already like super close, right? Bam, right there. Yeah. Can I use my bonus action to dash to the other guy?
Yes.
Loot both of them!
Are you taking teeth too?
No, you can
have it. So we're gonna go to our treasure deck we have here.
She tried to erase it before we even saw what she did.
Yes. Give me a die 12 roll.
Die 12? Ooh.
I get it.
See what these guys got in their pockets.
We do all the damage.
She hasn't killed a single person.
One.
That's always
good. One. She got a one. She got a one.
You are hanging out in the bushes.
Both of them happen to have a single large coin on them.
Ooh.
It is worth 7 gold pieces and 4 silver pieces.
Okay.
So like one big coin that's got a weird face on it. You don't think you've ever seen it before. It's definitely not something that any of the like kingdoms around have been minting. It's something different. You're not really sure where
it comes
from.
So one on each of them?
Yep.
And they're worth 7 gold?
7 gold, 4 silver apiece.
Mm-hmm.
All right. Sasha.
So she's done, so I'm going
You now notice your friend Calliope has not engaged in the battle.
Shout to my other two party members.
That's how I feel about you.
I'm shouting this to my other two party members.
Though? Yeah, no, I'm puking.
I'm letting them know. I'm saying, hey guys.
That's how I feel.
Hey guys.
We're talking to each other about how disgusted we are.
I'm saying, hey guys, Cal is evenly splitting that money with us, or we'll split it 3 ways.
I agree.
They don't even know this is going on.
We just saw you.
We know that you're not doing anything.
Busy.
We've been on 3 adventures with you. You do this all the time.
You always do, Cal.
You always do this.
Did you not see the picture I drew?
God.
That's me. I'm disgusted.
It's puking.
That also could represent me spitting acid in your face.
Puking ramen.
I will tell them I only found 1 coin.
Okay, all right.
And we will split that 1 coin 3 ways.
I'm gonna get you.
So Sasha, what are you doing?
So on the last remaining guy who's scared and terrified, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna cast blindness on him.
Nice.
Ooh. Humiliating. All right.
Level 2. So you're gonna spend this level 2 spell slot, hit him with a world blindness, and what does that do?
He's
what's the saving throw for that?
Saving throw is Constitution saving throw.
Constitution save, he got a 12.
Right, DC is 12.
DC is 12,
yes.
So you point your finger at him and your magic flies. It strikes him right square in the eyes and he kind of shakes his head a little bit, but he can still see.
Wait,
He made the save. He rolled the
12. I thought 12 worked.
12 makes it, yes. He made the 12, so your save failed.
But I thought when I cast the other one,
I rolled lower. I rolled lower.
I thought you rolled a 12.
No, I rolled.
Boo! So can I get? Oh, and they give you my inspiration. Right.
So he kind of shakes it off a little bit.
Inspiration.
And he made
whatever.
It, so.
I thought you had.
Cal's stupid.
Look,
we've all turned on you.
I am loyal to my friends, so I am obligated to share this three ways.
This is how I feel about the current situation.
Four ways. Four.
Sirioz, it is your turn.
Four. I forgot Sirioz there were four
is crying. Ways. Look at you have made Sirioz cry.
Sirioz is crying.
Look me in the face. Look what you've done.
No, my haft wagon.
You know what? You ruined all this. You were supposed to go and knock him out. If I can just torture him and take his teeth. Can someone just knock him out?
Can we have a sidebar for a second?
Can I hit him?
Yeah, you can.
Can we have a sidebar for a second? Because can we just look at Britain's drawing and how nice it is compared to everything else that we've tried to draw?
Very good.
I was an all state
artist. It's like a sad half
in the state of Massachusetts.
You've made the dragon cry.
Oh, that's a dragon.
Yeah.
What did you think it was?
So you know how like. You know how like Krang was like in that robot with the thing?
Oh,
I thought there was someone in something else.
You thought this
starfish.
Was a little frog in
I thought that was a starfish man with like something in his belly.
A starfish man?
Yeah.
Who's a starfish man?
I don't know. I thought it was you.
Your first thought while we're playing this game when he
sees
a
next
dragon.
To the dragon.
Is he drew a starfish man?
Haven't you ever looked at a picture and you can see two things?
Yeah, it's I like think that. It's perception, you know? Well, it's all.
You know,
all,
you know when you see, like, the old lady, the young lady. Yeah. The old lady, the young lady.
You saw Starfish Man.
I saw
and
Starfish
else.
Man with Krang in his belly.
I don't see a Starfish Man, though.
Okay, all right. Anyway, moving
all right.
on.
All right,
moving on.
Sirioz, you can certainly attack this
he's
guy.
He's blind, right?
No, he's not.
He's
no.
not blind.
He,
no,
shook, he shook it off.
What, you all tried right, to blind
well,
him and failed?
Yes.
Yeah.
I'm not going to slash him with the sharp part of my glaive. I'm just going to bash him with the stick.
All right, go ahead. Make your attack roll.
Okay.
Take him down.
See how you did that?
Die 20.
Yeah. I attacked instead of running. Oh, what's this?
I think that's a 20.
That's a 20.
Oh!
That's a crit.
Crit, roll, pick up your card, and let's see what your crit is.
If you do.
So bashing,
what
so
I think
bashing
do,
is the third one. So the third one down.
We're done.
Bash nose, triple damage.
Oh, smash, right square it up. So give me, roll your triple damage. So three die 10.
But if I find any magical weapons, you get that's about it.
10.
Because I can't use
crossbow.
Six.
Okay, so 24 points of damage.
Bam.
Yes,
plus
24
your,
points
plus
of
plus
3
for your strength.
Plus 3 for my strength.
So 27.
27.
That lays him out flat.
I just
boom.
Boosh.
Down, yeah. down he goes.
He's knocked out.
Knocked out.
There you go. So the goblins have been dispatched.
But he's not, he's still alive.
He's still alive.
He's still alive.
Yes.
I just broke his nose.
He can't
alive. I broke his nose.
Yes.
I barbecued the other one.
Oh. How'd you guys do that?
Partially. I want to torture him.
Wait, so what do you want to do?
Can we not loot those other ones?
Poor
just
little
killed?
Goblin you've knocked
so
out.
I want
you can totally go loot them.
I want to carve out the teeth of the ones that are dead.
I'm going to go
like full dental.
Why don't you get all the teeth?
Full medical and dental.
Why do you need to search?
Because I'm faster than you.
And then, this is true.
Oh, no, she didn't.
Oh, yes,
okay, what are you searching?
No, I want to search the bushes over here where I first saw the glint of metal.
Okay.
For any type of object or anything.
You can give me an investigation roll for searching.
Love that.
And then it's there's a thing. And then I'm after her.
Yeah.
Then
I'll do my. Oh, you can go first.
Yeah, you can go. We're out of round.
Okay.
At this point.
So I've taken the teeth from the dead ones.
Yes.
I want to tie the other one up.
Okay.
Like hog tied.
Okay, got it.
And I want to ask him. Where he, what his name is, where he's from, what they're doing out here.
Okay,
full
so
interrogation.
How do you wake him up?
By ripping up one of his teeth.
No, let's get some of this water from this lake and splash in his face.
You want to splash water?
Let's splash water.
Or do you want me to rip a tooth out?
I like how you're going from pulling out teeth, he's splashing water.
Yeah.
You're a waterborne goblin.
No, don't rip his tooth out when he's asleep. That's a waste of the.
So as they're doing that, just brutally torturing a poor goblin that tried to kill us.
You just saw his friend.
It's him. It's that one, right?
It's that one.
Oh, dope. Hold on. It's this one.
It's this one.
So while he's knocked out, we tied him up. Stripped him naked.
Okay.
Butt naked.
Little
what?
Naked guy.
He's hog-tied.
Hog-tied naked.
Butt guy. Naked, and we pulled him to the middle of the road.
Okay, in the middle of the road. Okay. You're so, investigating the bushes. What'd you get on your roll?
I got 12.
Okay, so you think you don't see anything here? You think probably the glint of the metal was off the armor of the goblin that was
hiding. Yeah, but they had to be stationed somewhere around here.
It's
possible.
I don't know. I'll check the other side where I saw the other goblins.
Okay, go ahead and check over there while they're playing Naked Goblin Twister.
Yes.
Not doing very well.
Yes.
The rest of us.
So, as you're rolling.
I got a 13 on the first one, sorry.
Okay, so you come over to this side and way past where the Dragonborn is now, like over in the bushes over in this area, mm-hmm. and you're finding tracks.
Okay.
You're finding probably a set of 10 to 15 goblin tracks, and it looks like they've dragged two bodies and gone off toward the northwest.
And then she's gonna loot them.
No, this is perfect. This is perfect. So okay, so we'll see.
She's gonna get us into another fight. You've got this naked goblin tied up.
What's your name again?
Serious.
Are you serious?
Yeah. Hanging out for days.
So we'll take his idea and splash the water in the goblin's face. We've woken him up.
Right. So you splash goblin water. What?
And as he,
don't hurt me! Don't hurt me!
Yes, nice. But he wakes up and he sees that I've got a crossbow pointed at his deal.
Don't hurt me! Don't hurt me! That's here!
So we say, tell us your name, where you're from.
And who is your daddy?
Who's your daddy and what does he do?
Crossbow is held like this, by the way. It's more like a gun. Yeah, cool.
It's my crossbow. It's a custom. It pumps like a shotgun.
I am Boglin.
Boglin the Goblin,
yes.
Okay.
Yeah, don't hurt me, please.
What were you and your friends doing out here?
Our job. Clark told us to come here.
Who?
Clark.
Who is Clark?
Clark is our boss. He's the master. Clark is the master.
Probably the one in the bushes that she's about to go
master.
Fight.
Master.
Or not fight. Just lure to us.
Look, I feel like we just need to pack up. There's probably some more gold stuff on these two over here.
We're gonna check
and
them.
Then we just need to go because there's way more goblins that head that way, like dragging two bodies.
Yes, he's right. They've gone that way.
No, well, who do they have?
We need to go this way.
Who did they take?
They took the dwarf and the human, and they went that way.
Mm. But we can go this way. But
those are the people who hired us.
Boglin will leave. Boglin will go good. I will be good.
You will.
Yo, yes, so, I will not be bad anymore. Please don't hurt me.
Okay, so.
We should make him our companion.
Companion, I think not.
Yeah, he's not joining us.
I say, so for attempting to kill us, I'm taking two of your teeth.
No, Clark made me do it.
You select which two teeth I take.
Hers!
You're gonna try to stab us in the back.
Which two teeth of yours I take, just for trying to kill us.
That didn't work, did it?
No.
Can I go slap him in the face?
Slap him.
I'm sorry, okay.
I'm deciding, I'm taking
out. I'm trying to spare your life.
I'm taking out your two front teeth.
No.
I pull out my teeth pliers.
I feel like he's really sidetracked.
Why do you have teeth pliers?
Because this is my deal.
You're a dentist?
I'm a cleric and I'm gonna use the teeth for magic stuff later. I take his two front teeth out.
Bam. That's a wizard. That's just that.
I can do what I want.
He doesn't even need the teeth.
I do. I want the teeth.
Blind.
Oh, why do you need the cupcake? Why? Because you want it. I want the teeth.
She probably looted it on the other two.
I popped two front teeth out. Right, I'm tied.
He's screaming at this point. He's screaming in pain.
He's screaming. And unless you want more of your teeth taken out, you're gonna do exactly what we say. We've tied him up for now.
You know that you pray to your god for magic, right? That's how you get your magic.
You don't even need
it. And I'm gonna give him teeth for sacrifice.
His god is a dentist.
Yes! It's Isaac Yankum. Isaac Yankum is my god in this game. So we've tied him up, so now his hands are tied up. Yep. The ropes are around his neck, too. Yep. So we've got him on like a body leash, like a bad child at the mall.
He's naked on a body leash?
He's naked on a body leash.
We don't even need him.
He's showing us where to go.
We saw the tracks. We know where they went.
But in case there's an ambush coming,
hold on.
He can tell us.
What he would tell
we've
us?
We've gagged him so we can't scream if he knows people are
so
coming.
So he can't tell anything?
No, he can't scream. So if we come on an ambush, he can't be like, they're here!
Well, maybe the most charismatic person can convince him to help us.
I don't want him anywhere near
us. He's helping us. I took his teeth. I'm going to take more teeth and lift me down.
Well, yeah, but maybe we can, secure it a little bit,
Yeah, by taking more teeth.
I don't think I should do any of that, man.
She's the most charismatic. She's not doing anything for us.
Yeah. She's not doing anything for us.
I don't need to do anything because I feel like we should go this way.
We can actually
keep the goods now.
We can't
and split
get
it any amongst ourselves and maybe give it to the poor. Hear me out here.
Actually, also,
we don't need to.
No, on the dead goblins and stuff, is some of their armor better than our current armor?
No, their armor might be a little better, but they're also goblin size, so it's not going to fit you.
They're not
going to
fit
you. However, now that you mention it, there are still two goblins that have not been searched for a treasure.
I'll search that company.
Yeah, I want to search one.
Who's faster?
You search everything!
Tarak is going to search.
She's friends with the goblin!
Yeah. We're going to the treasure deck. Give me a die 12 roll, Tarak.
12.
You got this, Tarak.
That is the one that kind of looks like a soccer ball. It's a weird looking one, yeah.
11.
Nice.
11. So 11 says, So it fits perfect, actually. They have short bows
nice.
That have fur-lined grip
Ooh.
And a quiver of 10 gray fletched arrows.
Ooh. Do you guys use arrows? Anybody use arrows besides me?
No, you
no,
use arrows.
No, that's all you, bro.
I use my
those are probably magic.
I give it to
thank
you kindly.
Thank you. Oh, when I strip the goblin naked, does that technically count as a treasure chest?
Treasure chest?
Researching
him? Put him on the body leash.
Yeah, sure, yeah.
We're going to cavity search him, too, see if he's hiding anything else.
He's not hiding anything else. He has the two teeth that you pulled out have no cavities at all in them.
They're like a naked body leash goblin.
Okay.
Are you putting your stuff in the goblin?
You can't use it as a little storage
unit. My mule. He's my pack mule.
He's just gonna carry your stuff around for you.
Hey, you guys got any gold?
He's a gold mule.
She stole it all.
Yeah.
You wanna pack it in the goblin?
I found these two large gold coins. I'm not going to pack them in the goblin.
Put it in the goblin.
Are we taking the goblin with us or are we leaving him?
I say we take him, but
I say we kill it.
I say we kill him.
All for killing, raise your hand.
Deciding vote. You really want to trust him next to us?
I just don't think he's, like, what is he going to do?
Look, he's going to turn on us at the first thing. He's naked on a body. He's going to fall asleep, you're
dead. When he turns on us, then I just kill him.
He called you a...
Don't kill Goblin. Don't kill Goblin. Goblin's good.
I got him, say it.
Death.
Did he call me ugly?
He totally called you ugly. Ugly.
What if you go on a walk for a second and come back and see what happens?
Alright, I'll go on a walk and I'll think it over, alright?
By the time you come back, they're gonna kill them already.
I'm gonna think it over.
They're gonna kill him.
I'm gonna go for a walk.
He's thinking, it's 2-1.
Hey, scissors?
No,
kills
we're on
goblin?
The same team. We say
yep.
kill.
Who kills the goblin? Which
one? It's 2-1 now. He's on a walk.
Death.
Oh, between who kills him?
Then here, at least let's make it sporting.
Okay, we'll let you kill him.
Can I use my assassin?
Not killing, but
to kill the goblin?
Right before they decide to kill him,
yeah.
I tell him.
I get it, man.
I tell him to run.
No.
The goblin?
No, it's sport now.
He's naked,
exactly.
Wait, I kill him before he lets go.
Okay.
easy enough, the goblin goes down the goblin.
And then I pout. I pout.
Hey, what happened?
She killed him.
Yeah. You killed the goblin.
I killed the goblin.
I was going to decide that we should let him live.
But since he called you ugly.
Since the goblin's dead, I take the rest of his teeth.
Okay.
I have 3 sets of teeth now.
All right.
And all I have a pouch. I have him in a pouch. Teeth pouch.
Wait. So now, okay. So what did you? Pouch. We got from searching the other guy. We got a bow and some 10 arrows.
Yep.
And then we got two large
coins.
10 arrows.
Correct. 10 gray fletched arrows.
Yeah. Well, you stole the coins for yourself.
10. She said that we get to all split them.
We're all gonna split it.
Yeah, I bet.
Gray fletched.
Yep.
I am disgusted by my.
If my character wasn't loyal to you guys, I would say you know you guys would have never heard from me again.
Because this bow. What was the bow?
It was a short bow.
I have a short,
sword.
Short bow
with a fur-lined grip.
Ooh, that's like sexy?
Yeah, sexy.
Okay.
Ooh.
You've replaced your bow.
It's like an UGG bow.
Yeah.
Although, give me a die 12 roll. Just for the hell of it.
No, where's the 12?
That's a 12. Yeah, that one, a weird looking soccer ball.
8.
That's, now you're kind of looking at it, you've got good senses because you're a cat.
Yeah.
This is cat fur.
Oh.
This is cat fur.
We can sell it though, can't we?
Is that weird?
I give it to them and they can do what they want with it. I'm no longer interested in the bow.
So I'll hold on to it till we get to a 10.
Well, actually, can I tell what kind of cat it's from?
Give me a nature check.
12?
Yeah. Die
about
20.
All cats?
And 20. Add your nature skill.
Okay.
Apparently not.
7. Nature 1. Minus 1, Jesus. So 6.
6, yeah, probably some sort of house cat, but you're not sure what kind.
Okay, I give it to them and they can do what they want with it.
I'll hang on to it till the town.
I'm suddenly sick.
I don't even think I can use it.
Told you, should have killed him.
Oh, that's where the line is? Pulling out goblin teeth and then cat fur. That's the line, right?
You wanted to with my own.
I'm just checking.
You wanted to send him running and have
you wanted to get his teeth.
I just want to know where the line is.
How did you go from mercy?
Because, listen, I don't talk about the thing that torments me. I'd rather not burden others with my curse, okay?
Yeah, wait, now if you did what's that, you got his inspiration back!
Hey, Sasha!
Hey!
You only have one, so you gotta spend it. All right, so what are you guys gonna do? Dispatch the goblins and...
Can we set up camp
and go to sleep? I say we continue down this trail here.
I'm so tired. I want my spells back.
It's 2 o'clock in the afternoon.
I want to use them so much.
That's your fault.
Fine. Fine, let's go.
Da-da-da-da-da!
da 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 da